Katrina, thank you very much for that very generous introduction. I will always cherish my relationship with Tom Lantos, not only in the service here in the nation's capital, in the House of Representatives, but we had the opportunity to travel together on behalf of human rights. And to see Tom Lantos in action, as I did in Hungary, as I did in the Baltic countries during the Soviet years, was a memory that I will never forget, and it's always been an inspiration to me. And I thank all of those that are involved with the Anne Frank Awards, what you've done, the Dutch Embassy, thank you very much for your extraordinary leadership, to our honoree, the work that you did during the Nuremberg trials is one of the most important moments in the history of mankind. So I thank all those that are involved. Mr. Ambassador, we particularly appreciate the Dutch Embassy and everything that they have meant to keeping this tradition alive. To Muhammad Ali Abdullah, it's an honor for me to acknowledge your extraordinary leadership and your being awarded the Anne Frank Special Recognition Award. Your work on behalf of social justice, the Syrian Justice and Accountability Center, to me is critically important to the work we all do in preventing atrocities. I'm proud that in the last Congress we were able to pass the Elie Wiesel Genocide and Atrocities Prevention Act and the also Syrian War Accountability Act. But I must tell you that your work in shining a light on what's happening in Syria motivated us to do what we did here in the Congress of the United States. What you are able to do in presenting to the global community the atrocities that are being committed by the Assad regime in Syria at great personal risk helps us to say that we will prevent atrocities from taking place. The public needs to see what is happening. It can't be hidden. And you made that your mission and the mission of the organization that you represent here. And that is so important to chronicle this for the history, to make sure that atrocities do not go unnoticed. But secondly, you also took great risks to preserve the evidence, to provide the ability for us, the international community, to have accountability for those who have committed these atrocities. So the evidence has been preserved in large measure to the work that you have done, so that never again one day will mean never again. Those that contemplate these types of atrocities need to know that it will go, that they will have their day in court, and they will be held accountable to the world community as they were in Nuremberg after the atrocities of World War II. And as I said, you did this at great personal risk. It's one thing for a United States senator to stand on the floor of the United States Senate and be critical of what's happening with the Assad regime in Syria. My safety is guaranteed. But to do that in Damascus, to do that in the world stage, where you don't have the protection of a democratic regime, you pay a very heavy consequence. And you were subjected to being in prison a couple times, and your personal safety was certainly at risk. So you are our hero, and a person rightly to be recognized. Elie Wiesel said, neutrality helps the oppressor, never the victim, and that silence encourages the tormentor, never the tormented. Well, I think we can all say Muhammad al-Abdullah has never been neutral, and he's never been silent. And for that, humanity has a champion who we honor today with the Anne Frank Special Recognition Award.